Hello everyone, today we're delving into a riveting development in the royal family saga. The release of Omid Scobie's latest book has sparked intense conversations, especially concerning the relationship between Princes Harry and William. This book, believed to be influenced by Meghan, has been seen as a divisive force, potentially dashing any hopes of mending the brothers' bond. For a while, there was a glimmer of hope for reconciliation. Imagine, if you will, a Christmas gathering with both brothers, perhaps not as close as before, but at least in a peaceful coexistence. Rumors even suggested Harry and Meghan might join the royal Christmas celebrations, a notion they reportedly welcomed. However, the atmosphere has shifted dramatically with Scobie's new biography. The book casts a shadow over these hopes, particularly with its portrayal of Catherine, the Princess of Wales. Scobie's words paint Catherine in a rather harsh light, labeling her as aloof and overly compliant with royal expectations. He even goes so far as to suggest she's gained a disparaging nickname, Katie Keene, for her adherence to royal duties. The book doesn't stop there. It contrasts Catherine's extensive royal engagements with claims of her being a part-time working royal. Moreover, it criticizes her for promoting mental health awareness while allegedly overlooking Meghan's struggles. These accusations are bound to stir a strong reaction from Prince William. It's not hard to imagine how any husband would feel about such stark criticism of his wife. This portrayal in Scobie's book seems to be more of a wedge than a bridge in the already strained relationship between the brothers. Continuing our dive into the royal family's latest saga, the new book by Omid Scobie is causing quite a stir, especially in its depiction of Catherine, the Princess of Wales. Scobie's portrayal suggests that Catherine's approach to her royal role is a stark contrast to the late Princess Diana's, hinting at a preference for Catherine's more coachable nature. This comparison, as you can imagine, not only casts a shadow on Catherine's image, who has played a significant part in revitalizing the Windsor family's reputation post-Megxit, but it also indirectly strikes at Prince William's beloved mother. What's intriguing here is the disconnect between Scobie's narrative and the public persona of Catherine. Known for her elegance and commitment to royal duties, Catherine has always presented herself with grace and a sense of genuine joy in her public engagements. She's mastered the art of being a relatable royal, understanding the power of image and the monarchy's global influence. Yet, Scobie seems to dismiss these attributes, framing her adherence to royal norms and lack of overtly ambitious pursuits as negative traits. In stark contrast, Scobie's book positions Meghan as a kind of modern-day Diana, a portrayal that seems a bit far-fetched and has raised many eyebrows. For William, the concern goes beyond the book's content. Scobie, known for his connections with Harry and Meghan, has publicly denied any close ties with the couple in relation to his book. This denial, however, hasn't done much to alleviate the tension it's created within the royal family. In the latest twist of the royal family narrative, the publication of Omid Scobie's book, Endgame, has everyone buzzing, especially Prince William. The big question on everyone's mind is whether the scathing remarks in the book have roots in Meghan and Harry's inner circle. This concern isn't just about the content of the book, it's about trust, a sentiment echoed by one of William's confidants who used to be close with Harry as well. They stress the need for Harry to openly disassociate himself from these narratives. However, many doubt that even this step could mend the fractured bond between William and Harry. It's hard to believe there was a time when Harry shared an equally close bond with both William and Catherine, forming a trio that charmed the world. Their dynamics, once a symbol of modern royalty, have drastically changed. Harry's persona before Meghan's entrance was that of a relatable, fun-loving prince. His military service and easygoing nature made him a public favorite. But with Meghan's arrival, a shift occurred. The question arises, was it Meghan's influence or Harry's challenges in integrating an outspoken Hollywood personality into the structured royal environment? This contrast was notably evident during a public event for their mental health initiative, Heads Together. Meghan, accustomed to expressing her opinions on various global issues, took a prominent role, leaving William and Catherine somewhat overshadowed. This moment encapsulated the changing dynamics within what was once referred to as the Fab Four of the royal family. In the intricate tapestry of royal affairs, Endgame, Omid Scobie's new book, seems to be a pivotal thread. Its release has stirred up concerns about the prospects of royal reconciliation, echoing the turmoil that began early in 2023 with Harry's own explosive book. the spotlight now turns to Meghan Markle, with Scobie's narrative suggesting she viewed her royal role as a platform to amplify her voice, a practice somewhat unconventional in the traditional royal setting. This approach starkly contrasts with Catherine's adherence to long-standing royal protocols. At the same event where Meghan shone, Catherine's more reserved presence was not a sign of dullness, but of her commitment to royal traditions and her role. This difference in approach has become a focal point in the ongoing royal discourse. The book's depiction of Catherine as a dedicated royal, spouse, and mother raises questions about why her commitment to these roles is portrayed negatively. Catherine's seamless adaptation to a public life, which she seems to genuinely relish, is often lauded. She's frequently praised for her integrity, honesty, and strong moral compass. In contrast, the book paints Meghan in a less favorable light, suggesting her intentions in joining the royal family were not long-term. This portrayal feeds into the narrative of a divide she allegedly caused within the family, casting her as a divisive figure. Harry's role in all this is also under scrutiny. The book implies that Harry, despite his royal birth, seems to misunderstand his role, which, according to some, is akin to that of a public servant. This misunderstanding is seen as part of the reason behind the current familial tensions. These controversies and portrayals in Endgame are only fueling more support for William and Catherine. The book, instead of dampening their public image, might be inadvertently reinforcing it. The ongoing saga in the royal family continues to captivate public attention, with each new revelation adding layers to an already complex narrative. As we continue to unravel the royal family's ongoing saga, it's impossible not to acknowledge the poise and dignity with which William and Catherine have navigated these turbulent times. Their composure hasn't just been a recent development, it's been a consistent trait throughout their years in the public eye. Their conduct has been exemplary, setting a standard of grace and resilience. Looking ahead, it's clear that William and Catherine will likely maintain this dignified approach. They've become a symbol of steadiness in the midst of the royal family's storms. Amidst all this, the future of Harry's place in the royal family becomes increasingly uncertain. The prevailing sentiment is that his actions are leading to an inevitable separation from the family, a development that carries a tinge of sadness for all involved, especially Charles. Meghan's role in this narrative is also a point of contention. Some view her as a less significant factor in the larger scheme of things, with the focus primarily on Harry and his choices. This unfolding story continues to capture the attention of royal watchers around the world. Everyone has their own perspective on the situation, and it's these diverse views that keep the conversation alive and engaging.